Pilate responded, "Then what should I do with this one who is called Jesus the Christ?" And the crowd shouted, "Crucify him!" "Why?" Pilate demanded. "What crime has he done?" Yet the mob cried again, "Crucify him!" And so it says in verse 26 that Pilate released Barabbas. I can't even imagine what he was feeling and thinking. Accused, ready to be executed, released because of Jesus. So Pilate released Barabbas to them, and he ordered Jesus to be flogged with a lead-tipped whip. And then they turned him over to the Roman soldiers to be crucified. Verse 27 says that some of the governor's soldiers took Jesus to the headquarters, and they called out the entire regiment. They stripped Jesus down and put a scarlet robe on him. They wove thorn branches into a crown and forced it on his head, and they placed a reed in his hand as a scepter. And then the soldiers knelt before him mockingly and taunting him, "Hail, King of the Jews," they said. And they spit on him. They grabbed the stick and they struck him on the head. When they finally tired of mocking him, they took off the robe and put his own clothes on him, and they led him away to be crucified. The Bible says that they led him to a place called Golgotha. It was known as the place of the skull. It was a place of execution. And there, the Jews, under the Roman authority, watched the centurion lay Jesus Christ on a cross. They nailed his hands and feet, and they lifted him up for all to see. The crowd continued to mock him. The soldiers mocked him. Even the high priest cried out, "He saved others. Let him save himself." The Bible says there was two thieves also being crucified that day, one on either side of Jesus. And one of the thieves continued just to rail on Jesus Christ, to taunt him and to mock him while he himself was being executed. Something happened in the heart of the other guy. The other thief cried out, "Why do you mock him? We deserve to be here. But this man has done no wrong." And then there was a movement of God in this guy's heart. Think about this. This guy's got nothing left. He literally has no chance to fix himself. He's got no opportunity to go to church for another time. He's never going to sing another song or give another offering. There's nothing he can do at this point to repay all the wrong he's done. So in mercy, he just cries out to Jesus,